analyst residing here in Lincoln, Nebraska. Today I want to talk to you about a 29-year-old Rosebud Lakota and Kiowa man named Zachary Bear Hills. I want to thank Maggie for sharing his story as well, but I want to delve maybe a little deeper. Who on June 5th, 2017 encountered four Omaha police officers at the Bucky's convenience store at 60th and Center Streets? Despite the fact that Zachary had committed no crimes that evening, those four officers proceeded to shock him 12 times with a taser, strike him 13 times in the face, and take turns putting their full weight on his back while he lay face down on the pavement with his hands zip-tied behind his back. When they turned him over to put him on a gurney that night, Zachary was gone. But we are expected to believe this unarmed, mentally disabled man died not from the gauntlet of abuse he suffered at the hands of these public servants, but rather from an obscure medical condition called excited delirium, which only seems to be applied by county coroners examining in-custody deaths and is not recognized by a single professional medical association. From the lack of crisis intervention training given to the four officers and their criminal misuse of their taser guns, to the incestuous relationship between the Douglas County Coroner's Office and Omaha law enforcement, Zachary's death should serve as a clarion call to all who seek to ensure justice is served in Nebraska. Are we to believe that county coroners, who receive much of their funding from contracts with local law enforcement agencies, will deliver independent autopsies when it comes to in-custody deaths? Indeed, I believe Nebraska should be willing to fund independent autopsies that are requested by families that have lost a loved one to police violence, or at the very least, require that such families are made acutely aware of their rights to request such independent autopsies. Another systemic failure that has plagued efforts to hold up the officers who murdered Zachary accountable is the right of officers to appeal their firings to independent arbitrators, who ultimately get to decide whether fired officers get their jobs back. In the case of the four officers involved in Zachary's death, all of whom were fired by Omaha Police Chief Todd Schmiderer, three will get to patrol the streets of Omaha again, a cold reality for Native people living in our state's largest city and a sad testament to our inability to hold our police accountable. I truly believe Zachary's murder won't be the last at the hands of police officers who know all too well the protections that are afforded them, including well-funded police unions, binding arbitration requirements, and the lack of independent oversight. It is for those reasons that I wholly support Senator Wayne's bill, because I am hopeful that knowing their actions would be scrutinized by independent citizen review boards will force any officer considering violence against a citizen to pause and reconsider his or her actions. And it is in the hope of such a moment of contemplation that I place my faith in LB 1222. Hope you'll Tonka. Thank you. Any questions?
Any questions from the committee?
So, yeah, thank you for coming.
Thank you.